We must be bold like never before to proclaim this gospel to the nations of the world. You know, the Global Evangelist Alliance asked me if I would speak on the subject of the reward of the evangelist. The reward of the evangelist. Right now, I want to pray. Holy Spirit, I pray that you would speak to every heart. That Lord, as they listen, as they receive by the Spirit of God, the word of the Lord, that their hearts would be ignited afresh. That Lord, there would be a fresh revelation that flows to every heart in Jesus' mighty name. Let your fire fall afresh upon them. Raise them up to be mighty voices to our generation in Jesus' mighty name. The reward of the evangelist. I want you to turn with your Bibles, please, to the book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 5. It says this. It says, unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, and hath made us kings and priests unto God and his Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. I also want to read from Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. This is what the word of the Lord declares. It says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. I just want to repeat that phrase just one more time. For who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, the reward of the evangelist. The Bible says that through the blood of Jesus, we have been made kings and priests unto God. Kings and priests. That through the blood of Christ, we have been brought near to the throne of God. That we are heirs of salvation. That we are sons and daughters of the Most High God. To be a king in the kingdom means that God has called you to take dominion. The Bible says that you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Romans 6:14 says, for sin shall not have dominion over you, for you are not under the law, but under grace. It's through the blood that the Bible says that we have dominion. And as heirs of salvation, we are to take dominion over that which the enemy has wrought in darkness. It is the power of the word of God. It is incredible to me that Jesus called the cross. He called his suffering. He called that all that he went through as he hung on the cross, as he bore the stripes upon his back, that he called that his joy. For the joy that was set before him, he endured the suffering. What a calling it is that we must also lay down our lives. The Bible says that through the blood, we are heirs of salvation. That means that we are kings and priests. We have been called to stand before him. That through the blood, we can stand boldly before the throne of grace. As priests, we are called to minister unto him. As priests, we are called to lay at the porch, between the porch and the altar, and weep before him. That we may be those vessels of honor that the Bible says that he may use in this hour. This is an eternal call. This is not about having a job or a title. This is the eternal call of salvation.
We invite you to join the Global Evangelist Alliance by visiting joingea.org. There you will find resources like the Evangelism Masterclass to help you boldly share your faith.